Live from his luxury penthouse apartment in London's glittering East End, Dean Lerner, club owner, entrepreneur, and publisher of high-class gentlemen's magazines, invites you to join him for an exclusive man-to-man.
Good evening and welcome to Man. Thank you so much for dropping by the Mansionette, right here at the top of Dean Towers. We have a great show for you tonight, but if you'll forgive me, I have just one bit of AOB to attend to first. This week sees the launch of my new pay-per-view television channel dedicated to girl-on-girl pillow fighting. And you can order it by phoning this number on the bottom of your screen. So just give our call team your credit card details and join in the harmless fun. And for billing purposes, charges to your card will be marked as office equipment. Now, my VIP visitor tonight is a towering figure in the world of sci-fi cinema for the home video market. Films such as Time Whackers, The Lactator, Frisk City Delta and Cop Gooses 1 through 8 have made him a hero to single men throughout the world. But he's perhaps best remembered for his pivotal role in the television series Galacticops, in which he played Bot, the alien with a human heart. His new autobiography, Bot Seriously, movingly describes his lifelong career with this historic show and is available from the Dean Lerner Book Club. And the number for that should come up at the bottom of your screen now. Order now and you can get my autobiography, I Have a Dean, Learning, Living and Loving with Dean Lerner for the reduced price of £90. But before I welcome this acting behemoth, let's turn back the clock and cop a look at one of Bot's finest moments.
It's too late for me, Jack. My time is over. Do not weep for me, for I have known many wonderful things in my life as the ship's chief pleasure port. Why, he showed me the reigning stars of Dramatricon 5. You showed me the twin moons of the Gantrax Helix, where we liberated the Hoodramans from their vile slave masters, restored the mighty Opteryx. And you showed me that game with those majestic colored orbs. What was the name of that game, Jack?
Snooker.
Snooker. Snooker. Mourn not my passing, for we Batrakans do not fear death. The knowledge of my people may be passed on to those who have joined our everlasting quest for courage, wisdom, and above all, dignity. Let us perform the rite. My friend.
Please give a warm, intergalactic welcome to Mr. Glynn Nimron.
Greetings, Captain.
A at ease, soldier.
Thank you.
Take a seat. It's great to see you looking so well, Glynn.
Well, thank you very much, Dean, and thank you for your wonderful introduction. Although we in the business never use the term sci-fi. It's SF.
SF.
That's right. SF for scientifical fictions.
Right. Not sci-fi.
Never sci-fi. De Montfort Grainy, the wonderful creator of Galactic Ops, he despised the term sci-fi, like he despised Orientals. It's a simple mistake to make, but one I feel should be rectified. Could we have the fire down a little lower, please?
Yeah, sure.
It's just, I can no longer endure a heat source stronger than 25 degrees centigrade. So I don't know if your cameras can observe, but my forehead is already susceptible to finger indentation.
Sure.
So, could you let me know if you notice any discharge?
Sure. I'll be the first to let you know, should you discharge.
Thank you. Thank you.
And if you could do likewise.
Of course.
There's a bit of a whiff, actually, if you don't mind me saying.
Well, that's a chemical compound. It's a skin healer, and it cools the skin from within. It's being patented by my surgeon, but it's not in the stores yet because, unfortunately, it's still highly flammable.
Okay. Can we let's have this fire down a little bit lower? Yeah. Okay. Can I just say it's such an honour to have you on the show? I mean, I've had many achievements in my life. I now own 6 nudie bars. I've met both of the Proclaimers. I actually refereed a tug of war between them and Tears for Fears. But really meeting you is the culmination of everything. I'm such a huge fan. It really is the best moment of my entire life, and I'd just like to thank you so much for coming on the show.
Well, thank you very much, Dean.
Thank you very much. And I'd like to thank you for coming all this way, because you've flown in straight from Hawaii, haven't
That's
you?
Right, yeah.
You're half Hawaiian.
That's right. My father was a Hawaiian fire breather, and my mother was a nurse in a hospital burns unit. And ironically enough, on their first date, my father belched at the wrong moment and set her alight. She was a beautiful woman, my mother, on the left-hand side.
She was certainly a striking presence in any room. And I really enjoyed reading your new autobiography, which I believe is the 6th you've written.
Well, I tried squeezing them into 5, but they just wouldn't fit.
Wouldn't fit. Lovely. But this is a special one, isn't it? Because it's the first book in which you discuss candidly your relationship with the creator of Galactic Ops, De Montfort Grainy.
That's right. He was a genius. You know, and I think the thing is we shared a vision in Galactic Ops because on the one hand, it was a futuristic cop show, but on the other, it dealt with some pretty fundamental human themes.
Indeed, yes.
Tolerance, compassion, love, understanding, water sports, and above all, dignity. Human dignity, which is something De Montfort never lost, right up until that final rectal prolapse which ended his filmmaking career.
Sure. And I'm so proud because we've managed to film you reading that book for DVD, and that should be out soon on the DVD label.
Well, well, that was on your suggestion, Dean.
Well, yes, I mean, after reading your book, I thought perhaps it might be even more appreciated by the illiterate. And the thing is, if you can tap into the illiterate market, your quid's in, because they can't read the reviews. So, let's take a look.
Hello, I'm Glynn Nimron, and welcome to volume 1.9 of my digitally versatile Discal Biog. If you've bought this box set expecting to meet Bot, well, you're going to be disappointed. Bot is under my strictest instructions not to interfere. Greetings. I am Bot. Hey, Bot, didn't I specifically tell you not to interfere? It is in my nature to help those who are struggling. Well, I'm managing very well here on my lonesome, thank you. Now get out of here. As you wish. Gee, I hope he doesn't pop up again unannounced. I first met De Montfort Grainy when I was just a young actor in some long-forgotten television drama. I'd never even heard of the great director, but one evening as I was hosing off my makeup in my dressing room, he came to me and made his feelings known. Glynn, he said, drawing the shower curtain closed behind him, Glynn, I've been watching you. You have the physique of an astronaut. I want you to play Bot in my new film. And by the way, you're using that loofah all wrong. This is how it's done. The rest of that evening is now, sadly, just a haze. But one thing was certain. A new and powerful force had entered Glynn Nimron. The following day, I feverishly devoured De Montfort's script. Bud had five lines. How the hell was I gonna learn all this material? I was terrified. I'd only ever had one speaking role to date, and that was the line, "Please don't shoot me, I'm new to this country." So I consulted De Montfort. "Mr. Graney," I said, wringing my hands nervously, "maybe you should go hire another actor." He listened, steadied my nervous wrists by securing them tightly to my ankles, and whispered, "Glynn, I don't want an actor, I want you." The rest of that lunchtime is now sadly just a haze. But one thing was certain, Bud was back.
"Did someone say my name?"
"Hey, don't make me use this."
And it stays as funny as that for the next 30 hours. And now, Boss is obviously your most famous, well, only famous character. How would you describe him to the countless millions and millions of people who have no idea who he is?
Well, very simply, Bud started out as Trainee Counselor 3 on board the Galacticops cruiser, the Galacticat, and fast became a firm favorite with the fans. But I'm pleased to say that by film 13, Bud had completed his training and been promoted to co-deputy assistant secretary to the advisory board for the vice chief counselor's junior ombudsman standing committee.
There was quite a physical demand upon your person in the role, wasn't there? De Montfort did push you, didn't he? Didn't he put you on an estrogen diet so you could grow your own breasts?
Yes. Yes, he did do that, but you know what? Whenever I was anxious, De Montfort would pop a reassuring thumb up my ass and the whole worry of the world would just melt away from my shoulders.
Now, I'm about to embarrass you, Glynn, because I've had a dream ever since I was a little nipper that one day I might perform in a scene with my favourite actor of all time, Chuck Norris. Only joking, Glynn Nimron. I've got a script here which I've written. It's based on my autobiography. It's my life story. And I'd love you to take a look at the part of my mother.
Okay.
I've got it. Hang on, I need to open. Sorry, could you hold this?
Oh.
Oh, Jesus Christ! Put him out! Put him out! Put him out! Okay, all right, okay. Cut to the pillow fight! Cut to the pillow fight! Put him out! Put him out! Put him out! Welcome back. For those of you who've just joined us, my guest tonight, Glynn Nimron, has partially melted as a result of an accidental fire in the studio. It was an act of God. Nothing could have been done to prevent it. Glynn's skin, however, is very thin, due mainly to years of surgical grafting for breast augmentation. The top of his head has come away, his shoulders are slightly crispy, and his nipples have begun to weep. He's being kept cool backstage in the man-to-man hospitality suite where he is currently awaiting a doctor. He's comfortable, he's being kept moist, he's having hot milk and cake, and we've managed to cut him safely out of his trousers. Our cameras are in there, the lighting is lower than we'd like, but Glynn is both willing and contractually obliged to continue... to continue talking to us. Glynn, can you hear me?
Oh, boy.
OK, Glynn.
Okay. Oh, wow.
Yeah. Are you all right?
I'm fine, Dean. I'm just sorry we couldn't complete our script.
Well, I've still got the script, and it'd be great if we could still go through it.
Sure. Actually, I don't think that's a good idea, Dean. I'm burned pretty bad.
It's all right. Satu can hold up the script for you.
Oh.
I'll set the scene for you. I'm in the middle of...
Oh!
Hey, come on. Bub. I'm in the middle of opening up my first lap dancing club and I receive a phone call saying my mother is critically ill. It's your line first.
Oh, Jesus, I'm so goddamn hot.
No. it's actually, I'm so proud of you, Dean. I'm sorry to do this to you on your big night. And then it's my line. Don't worry, Mother, I forgive you. Can you not die for another hour? Gaz Top is here, and the press are clamouring for a photo of us together. No. That's not it either, Glynn. We'll pick this up later. We'll play in the VT and we'll come back, Glynn.
I don't think so, Dean. I'm burned pretty bad.
Yeah. Yeah, no. You've said. Now, earlier this year, I gave Glynn a camera. Well, lent, though he seems to have taken it as a fucking gift. And I asked him to give us an exclusive insider's view of the 14th Uxbridge Science Fiction and Fantasy Convention.
Hi, I'm Glynn Nimron, and I'm here in Uxbridge, England, for the 14th annual Uxbridge Science Fiction and Fantasy Convention, held this year in the Uxbridge Conference Center, right here in Uxbridge. It's a little rainy, it's a little early, so I'm going to go grab a continental breakfast in my hotel, which, lucky for me, is situated just across the way there. Come on, I'll buy you coffee.
Galacticos, Galacticos, we are planet needs a hand, that's where we will be. Galacticos, Galacticos, bringing justice to the galaxy.
Glynn Nimron.
No.
No?
No, really, no. There's nothing here.
Oh, maybe they put it under my travelling pseudonym, which is Mr. Milk.
No.
What about Bot? They could have put it under Bot.
Oh, Bot's 9,000.
That's the one. That's it. It should actually be 10,000. I got promoted in the last film, but that's fine. They got the script wrong. That's their problem, not yours.
Okay, so how'd you like to pay?
Oh, I thought it was paid for.
Not yet, no.
Oh, okay. How much is it?
It's 45 for a double.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome onto the stage, Mr. Glynn Nimron.
Hello, Uxbridge, how are you? Great, or as I should say, as Bob would say, Splenmatma Wernoff Vo. You got it. Great. You know, it's wonderful to be here among so many familiar faces. In fact, bang goes my speech. You guys all heard it last year.
Hi there. Yes, it's £5 for a pre-signed photograph and £10 if I sign it in front of you. And for another £10, I'll take my top off. No, seriously, just my shorts.
ADT checks.
I'll take just about anything. Hey, I've had an idea. Why don't you just sign it and I'll fill it in? No, I'm only kidding. £10. That's great.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
William.
William comes from the German Wilhelm. Will meaning desire and Helm meaning helmet. So I can quite legitimately say to you, William, I desire your helmet and there's nothing you can do about it. So think about that.
In fact, I'm going to give you a discount. That's £9.50. And I will see you in the bar, hopefully. And
can I get a picture with you?
Of course you can. Right. First, take your 50p change.
Thank you.
Come over here.
Thank you.
Okay, come down to my level.
Sorry.
Okay. I can't do a discount for children. £10, £10, £10, £10. So £40?
Could we just take the one, then?
Please? Take the one. Okay, but I can only sign it to one of them.
Could you not do that to the table, please? Well, I've had a wonderful time. I've had one dirty banana too many. But it's good night from me, and it's good night from William here, who has very kindly agreed to give this aging old alien a bed for the night. So thanks for joining me, and I hope to see you all again next year. Over to you, Dean.
In the last couple of minutes during that VT sequence, Glynn's condition has sadly worsened. My personal physician is in there with him. He's a breast specialist. He's done all of my girlfriends. And he has told me that Glynn has to have an immediate quadruple breast bypass to stop the seepage, or he'll drown in saline. So, Phil, how's he doing?
We're going to have to go now, Dean. I'm sorry.
Yeah, OK. Well, sure. No problem. Our thoughts are with you, Glynn. We hope you pull through. It doesn't look good. And out of respect, I've chosen not to continue our reading of my script. We did have one opportunity to perform together way back when, though, on my old show, Dino's After Dark. Glynn was a regular visitor there after the cancellation of Galacticops, and around this time, he was trying to salvage his flagging singing career. So, at his behest, we, for the first and only time, sang a duet together. This is for you, Glynn.
Thank you. No idea.
I wonder where he could be.
Indeed.
I'll take a look. Glynn, where have you been? The party started ages ago and the girls are about to strip. Come and join in the fun.
No, Dean, I don't feel like it. I just want to look out this window for a while.
But why look out the window? There's nothing to see. And I can offer you far more attractive sight through there. Be a sport.
I don't know, Dean. It's just not me. I've always felt different from you guys. Maybe that's why I love stars so much. They don't judge. In fact, there's a lot of places you can go looking out a window. Just wondering and wandering.
I knew a little boy, the saddest kid in town. He used to have a mom and dad, one burned and then one drowned. He'd play with little robot toys, spacemen were his thing. And when his uncle came at night, he'd look outside and sing, I'm wandering and wandering across a field of stars. My bedroom since my parents died has felt like prison. Gulfs of space and time and Saturn's magic rings. There's space dust, rockets, shooting stars, and no more horrid things. I'm just wandering, we're wandering.
Fair enough, but if you change your mind, just come through. There's rubbers in that drawer.
Please, Baker, you've got to want it.
Come on. You've got to want it, Glynn. Yeah, that's his last interview. You can see it in the eyes. It's gone. It's gone. It's completely gone. The fight's not there.
Good show?
Yeah, wasn't too bad, actually. It was quite a good one tonight.